lost a year ago. But Maria Butyrskaya won't give up her place atop the podium without a fight. European champion Irina Slutskaya is hungry for her first world gold. But is 14-year-old American Sarah Hughes the new heir to the throne? Only one will ascend to the top. Who will be crowned the world's best? Find out next. Time in the south of France. Tonight, though, they're not headed up the coast to Monte Carlo to check out the casino. They're right here in Nice as we welcome you inside the Palais des Expositions. Back to the 2000 World Figure Skating Championships. Which lady will skate away with the gold medal? We are about to find out. The final group on the ice warming up for their free skate. And hi again, everyone. Terry Gannon along with Peggy Fleming and Dick Button. Two Russians, two Americans round out the top four, and now each has 4 minutes on the ice all alone. Those 4 minutes helping to define the rest of their careers. And Dick, these top four couldn't come from more different backgrounds.
Well, you know, what we have to remember is that Maria Butyrskaya and Irina Slutskaya come from a really different lifestyle than ours. I mean, they have not moved to an American suburb dotted with malls. At 15, Maria Butyrskaya survived being kicked out of the Central Army Sports Club because they said simply that she had no future in figure skating. And she survived her car being firebombed. Now, Irina Slutskaya wasn't even selected for last year's world team, yet both of them are here. Their need for success is overwhelming. They are, like so many skaters in their country, truly hungry.
The comeback season has been amazing for Irina Slutskaya. Look at what she has done this season after being on the brink of retirement last season. She's won her last four competitions, three of those over Maria Butyrskaya, Dick.
Well, it's really wonderful what's happened to her in the last year. I mean, there has been a total transformation. Costumes, choreography, enthusiasm. Note particularly her triple-triple jump combinations and the confidence that she's exuded.
We turn our attention to Peggy Fleming and now the Americans. And Michelle Kwan, who won two world titles, but now Peggy in third place. A lot of work to do. She has to win the free skate and have Maria Butyrskaya finish no higher than third to win.
Well, Terry, the pressure on Michelle to do her triple-triple is immense at this point. She is in third place and needs that technical advantage, even if Butyrskaya and Slutskaya don't. And now for Michelle to have drawn first in the skate order is the worst-case scenario. The judges will leave room for the other skaters.
And what about the other American here? 14 years old, Sarah Hughes, she's 4 years away from being able to vote, but she's among the top skaters in the world already.
Well, Sarah Hughes has an equally, if not more, difficult program than the leaders. She's an amazingly focused and elegant 14-year-old, but will that youth help her or hurt her tonight?
All right. Predictions are always dangerous, but right now we're on the spot. Dick, what do you like here?
Well, I hate being on the spot, but I'll tell you, I'll take Maria Butyrskaya simply because I like to play the contrarian and because I like to support the most fragile skater.
Conservative pick. She's in the lead right now. Come on. I'll take Irina Slutskaya. I love the comeback story. How about you, Peggy?
Well, I'm going to stick with Michelle Kwan because you never can underestimate her. And I think that the two Russians, Butyrskaya and Slutskaya, are going to mess up a little bit.
Ooh. A little bit of a disadvantage, though, as you mentioned, Peggy, because we look at the skate order. Michelle's on the ice first, and the judges do always leave room after the first skater. Then Butyrskaya and Slutskaya, fourth and fifth, they skate back-to-back, and Sarah Hughes waits around and skates last. For Michelle Kwan, ever since her loss at the Worlds last season, she has learned the only thing constant in life is change. It was supposed to be a showcase for the finest artist in the world, Michelle Kwan, to defend her title. But it has turned out to be Maria Butyrskaya's event.
After last year's Worlds, I thought I had a lot to learn. I've made a lot of changes, especially with school, in my life. I can't even compare it. It's two different sort of lifestyles. And I like the lifestyle I'm living right now. When I decided I'm going to go to UCLA, a lot of people were like, Michelle, you can't do it. But no, I'm proving them all wrong.
School or no school, even when she is skating well, Michelle's been plagued by the criticism that her programs lack enough technical difficulty to consistently raise her above the competition. Her second place finish at the Grand Prix final sent a clear message.
Well, I'm glad I was able to compete at the Grand Prix finals because I was able to see where I stand position-wise against other skaters. I knew that I had to up the ante, change a few things in my program.
Now that she's added the tougher elements, Michelle needs to make them work. Even without the triple-triple at U.S. Nationals, she took home the gold. But she'll have to do better than that to win here.
I feel more prepared than I did at Nationals. I'm having fun. And I think what I love most about skating is competing. And so here I am.
She recently moved out of the dorm at UCLA to an apartment closer to her training site, cut down on her class load to concentrate on skating. She hasn't finished lower than second since 96 at any event.
Well, she can't back off at all in this program. And as her coach Frank Carroll says, that's the way of sport. You have to continue to make progress or you'll get left in the dust. She's opening with a triple loop.
She has upgraded this from the double axel she normally did.
Very solid.
You notice all of these opening jumps are what I call gentle jumps. They're not approached aggressively, but with elegance and calmness. And that was just first rate.
Very smooth. Now this is her most important element, her triple-triple combination, which is one of the more easy ones, the triple-toe, triple-toe.
Oh, good for her. You know, she's skating with greater speed in this program so far. She's really attacking it very nicely, and I like to see that.
Now the triple salchow. Nice arm positions in that layback spin.
Jump. Good one. Wonderful, wonderful exiting edge. Clean, straight, beautifully lined out.
Trying to become the first American to win three world titles since Peggy Fleming.
That would be a nice addition.
Running butterflies into a death drop, back sit spin, good back position.
This free skate 4 minutes in length, worth 50% of the overall score.
Trademark moves, this spiral change of edge, sequence of steps. Jump.
here. She's just taking one element at a time.
Look at this circular footwork. This frog position. Shades of Tenley Albright in the 1950s. Back Charlotte Spiral.
This is only the second time she's done a clean program since 1998 at the Olympics.
But the wonderful thing about it was that she really attacked the program. She skated with speed and aggressively. She did not pull back. She had more energy in this program than I've seen her give in a long, long time. And that's refreshing and wonderful to see.
The air of invincibility may be gone at this point, but not the heart of a champion.
But she's back up on the pedestal right now. Now, what she had to add to the program was this increased difficulty of a triple-triple. First a triple toe, watch the beautiful revolutions, cleanness and the smoothness and easiness into the second triple toe. Not the most difficult triple-triple combination, but awfully good. And this forward move here into a triple flip. Wonderfully good. Look at how clean and perfect that is. Not a bobble to it. That's the kind of jumping that we have to see. And she did it all with energy. I'm really impressed.
There's a look at the nine judges who are randomly selected by draw. And by the way, there is no USA or Russian judge on the panel. Like, what are they looking for?
Well, first and foremost, they're looking for a really well-balanced program. That means a good mix of spins, jumps, and footwork. They're looking for quality positions, extensions and spirals, for example. They're looking for originality of the presentation and for wonderful footwork, speed, quality of edges, originality of steps.
She's often said it's all about the process, not the outcome. But it would be pretty nice if the outcome matched the process.
Absolutely.
As well.
You know, really, it doesn't matter because she did it, and she did it right. And that's the important element here.
The first set, 5.6 to 5.8.
But they're good. 5.6 is a little low, I think, for that combination to move. But, you know, again, the satisfaction comes from the performance. And that's what she'll remember. She won't remember the marks.
The marks for presentation, the 5.8s, the 5.9.
Almost 5. A lot of 5.9s and a lot of 5.8s.
Backstage, Michelle Kwan. Flowers in hand. Got the water, got a large smile on her face. Toughest part now, she's got to deal with the media and then wait around to watch the others skate, including the leader after the short program, Maria Butyrskaya, who's up in a little bit. A reminder tomorrow, two of golf's great names. The ladies' free skate underway with the final group here in one of their own. Vanessa Guzmaroli, the current French national champion, the 97 world bronze medalist, in fifth place after the short program.
Vanessa had the skate of a lifetime just a month ago at the European Championships. She's hoping to repeat that same performance, opening with a triple lutz, double toe. Nice spring.
Seeing here is a skater who is a steady, secure athlete. She's a straightforward skater. Look at this triple loop. There are no excessive movements. There are no excessive arm flailings. Very fine and superb athlete. She's also the national water skiing champion in the under 21 category. A snowboarder, a skier, a golfer.
Does a little bit of everything.
What does she do in her spare time?
Skates.
that ankle injury that she battled for the first half of the season was really bad. She withdrew from her Grand Prix events, finally skated at the French Nationals and won, and then the fourth place finish at Europeans that you mentioned, Peggy.
Triple Salco. Struggle on the landing.
Straightforward, solid skater.
And very pleasant to watch. This is a very well choreographed program for her. Good pacing.
Up so easily.
That is very difficult to do.
This layback position, mediocre. But I like the combination of spins that she does right here. A camel spin first to the left, a sit spin.
It's an unusual, very inventive position in the sit spin.
And then a camel spin to the right. Shades of John Curry, the great English champion. And one again to the left, who did that kind of left-right-left left spinning. Well, good for her. What a difficult place to skate right after Michelle Kwan's superb performance. And then to follow it up with a solid one of her own is just terrific.
The look of disbelief on her face at the end, knowing that she did so well here at Worlds. Most of the French skaters have talked about how difficult it has been, even though they appreciate the support, but they feel the weight of all these fans on their shoulders, the expectations.
This was her opening jump, the triple lutz double toe. She did this with such confidence and control. Nice and straight in the air. Good flow into the following jump, the triple toe. And now the triple loop. Good edge, that back outside edge takeoff. Straight in the air. Really neat with her feet. She's very precise. Good turning in the air. And this was her split that she did on the ice. This is so difficult to get down and then come back up. That was very smooth.
Peggy, when your makeup is smeared from tears of joy, that's okay, right?
That's all right. Yeah, that's cool.
That works.
Well, those are very nice marks. You know, the point, the actual count is she did six triple jumps to Michelle seven. But who's counting?
The judges.
Yeah. And we are.
Presentation marks now.
Also very good. I mean, they're very generous marks. She's a very solid, straightforward skater. She's not a theatrical performer. And she doesn't have wild emotion, but very steady.
Second place right behind Michelle. The ladies continue to skate for gold here at the World Figure Skating Championship. After this message and a word from our ABC station. Here in Nice, American Sarah Hughes. Fold under the pressure? No sign of that yet for the 14-year-old. She is still to skate.
Yulia Sebastian.
Meanwhile, the ladies' free skate continues. Maria Butyrskaya, Arina Slutskaya, Sarah Hughes still to come. Right now, Michelle Kwan in the lead. But here is Yulia Sebastian of Hungary in sixth place after the short program.
She has good energy to her programs. jumps are very light. She doesn't seem to dig into the edges on the takeoffs.
Of Irina Salutskaya. How about Yulia? 19th at Worlds and right now 6th here. Worlds being last year's Worlds in Helsinki.
She did too.
Well, she's been the second best skater in Hungary the last couple of years. Diana Pope has been the top skater, the national champion. Yulia finished 6th at the European Championships in Vienna recently.
Now this triple lutz again that she attempted to do at the beginning. Much better. For the double toe.
She has good straight legs that are very tightly crossed in the air.
Sebastian, not the free skate, obviously, that she was hoping for here. Great stage, but
just too many mistakes.
Yeah.
Well, this young lady is a wonderful athlete, and she moves beautifully, and that was nice right up to there, but then she did not push that leg up, the landing leg up, landed with the free leg too far in front, and just sat down.
Well, the downside of being out there all alone for 4 minutes and now you have to wait, see what other people thought of what you just did.
Well, you can see the reaction on her face. She sees the marks on the monitor, and they're not good ones with a 4.9 in there. She's really very talented, and if she could get all of this under control, I think she'd be a very formidable competitor.
And only 18 years old. from Budapest. And now the marks for presentation, 5.1 to 5.4.
Somewhat more. She has energy.
So Yulia Sebastyan currently in fourth place. Meanwhile, backstage, Michelle Kwan looks awfully relaxed right now. You know, inside, it's a much different story. And Maria Butyrskaya making her way out, trying to remain the only Russian woman ever to win a world ladies title. Only she, Tara Lipinski, and Slutskaya have defeated Kwan since 97. And she goes to the Bolshoi, actually learns a lot, and applies it to her skating. The world champion takes the ice when we come back.
On the ice, representing Russia,
Maria Butyrskaya.
Back in East, the World Figure Skating Championships and the ladies' free skate, Maria Butyrskaya, the defending world champion, taking the ice and the leader after the short program. Right now, it's Michelle Kwan at the top, followed by Vanessa Guzmaroli, in terms of those that have skated here in the free skate.
Just when we think her nerves may be resurfacing, Maria comes through and shows us how tough she is. She skated a very clean short program. See if she can do this again in this long program. She's opening with the triple Lutz.
Very good.
Strong edge on that landing.
What's the landing edge in particular? Watch the knees and the way she sinks into it. It's all very stiff, but she's landing them and she's doing them. And that's the most important thing.
Well, she definitely has determination.
Her coach said the only two people here in Nice who talked about Maria actually winning again were her and Maria. So many times people have written her off and just given up on Butyrskaya.
Now watch this combination, a very unusual and difficult one. First to triple toe. Half loop. Triple salka. Ah, and you see she just didn't have the swing and the rhythm from the first and the second jump. She was unable to get up in the air and complete the triple part. That's unfortunate. But here she has a triple loop.
Nice.
Position is so-so.
The leg could be more turned out and more arch in her back. Stretched out, her spirals compared to Michelle Kwan and Sarah Hughes doesn't even match at all.
Triple salchow that became a double. So far, final combination spin. Now watch the camel position. Watch the way she goes down with back arms. Back sits thin. Interesting position.
You know something? She should really be pleased with that. She had only the one mistake in the triple half loop, triple salchow combination, and she doubled one jump, but there's nothing to be taken off for that. So I would think she'd be very happy with it. It just didn't have the excitement that she sometimes achieves.
Inconsistencies throughout the season. They set her car on fire. She lost three times to Arina Slutskaya.
It's been a rough year.
Yeah, here she is at the World Championships with a chance to win. We'll see how much the mistake costs her. Michelle Kwan waiting to see how the others skate. Just loosening up backstage, a smile on her face because she was great. But the fact is, she needs Maria Butyrskaya to finish third or lower. Remember that, to have a chance to win.
Now her triple Lutz shows really how kind of stiff she is as a skater. Watch the landing edge, but otherwise it was a very good jump. I mean, that was really quality jumping. And this combination, though, she had trouble. First, with the triple toe right there, half jump. You can see that half jump just did not have the rhythm with it. She never got up into the air. The jump really went off from the back inside edge right at the beginning of it, and that destroyed that combination.
Michelle Kwan, Vanessa Guzmaroli right now, as we await the marks for Butyrskaya. Because of the scoring the way it is now, the free skate worth 50% with the qualifying round as a part. A couple of years ago, the free skate was worth two-thirds. Five, and if you're in the top three and won the free skate, you were the automatic winner. No more. Technical merit marks.
Well, you see, they're not as good as Michelle Kwan's, but they're very strong, and they're just fine for the way she skated and what she did. Again, the question comes in the fact that she must be down quite a ways before Michelle Kwan can pull up over her.
And now the marks for presentation. There they are. And currently in first place, her free skate actually judged second best to Michelle Kwan. But overall, Maria Butyrskaya has the lead on Kwan now. Butyrskaya's Russian counterpart, Arina Slutskaya, warming up. The first to land that triple-triple combination. That was at the Grand Prix Final. Awful year last season. Didn't even skate at the Worlds. And an avid snowboarder. She'll take the ice looking for the gold medal when we come back to the World Championships.
Denise Buhlman, the first woman to land a triple Lutz in competition, used this jump in a flawless performance to win the 1981 world title. She remains the only Swiss skater to win a world title in the past half century. But she's best remembered for her extraordinary flexibility and popularizing what is now known as the Buhlman spin. Incredibly, today at age 37, she's still doing triples and is one of the top competitors on the pro circuit.
At the World Championships, where Arina Slutskaya is just moments away from taking the ice. She's gone from celebrated prodigy to oblivion and back. Now she's on the brink of what would be her greatest achievement yet. Arina Slutskaya has never been happier. Fresh from her gold medal triumph at Europeans last month, she's hungry to reach the goal she set when she was 6 years old, a world title.
You know, I'm really happy I can win Europeans. I win like first time, and now I want to work one, more, because I have a dream. I have a dream about winning the world championship.
The center of the podium is not a new place for Slutskaya. At age 16, she won her first of back-to-back European titles. She was the future of Russian skating. Then, after a silver at the 98 World, she didn't even make the 99 World team. Those chubby cheeks, cute in her youth, became a problem at age 20. She had lost her edge and her desire to skate.
I don't want to talk about last year. I hate those last year. It's so difficult. Of course, I have moments when I don't want to skate, and I don't want to do nothing, I'm just crying and everything like this. But, you know, I start a new season and I change lots of things.
No trace of body fat remains on her sleek new figure. With more money and freedom than most 21-year-old Russians, she's a young newlywed living a busy, exciting life in Moscow. She and her husband, a former boxer, live in a new apartment. And Arena loves to explore her neighborhood.
А дайте, можно мне журнальчик в ручки взять один? How is looking? It's me. It's me again. ABC Sport. Спасибо. Это не наши. Ой. You want chocolate? It's true. I love this chocolate.
Irina is re-energized. Passed over last year, she's now a favorite to win a world title.
I think I have now everything. I have a husband. He's nice. I want to do something, you know. Last year I didn't want to skate. Now I want to skate. I want to see something new. I want to jump. I want to fighting, you know, with my sportsmen. I mean, on the ice. And I have some new ideas and... Like new life.
Sur la glace, représentant la Russie.
On the ice.
Almost entirely reinvented herself after nearly quitting in frustration last season. Arina Slutskaya takes the ice. You saw the leaders, Butyrskaya, Kwan, and Guzmaroli. But here is the 21-year-old from Moscow, the European champion. Back three times, 96 and 7. She became the first Russian or Soviet woman to win that title. Won it again this year. Look at how loose she is. Joking with her coach.
She still has those wonderful red cheeks.
Yeah, that you pinched at the European Championships a few years ago.
And which she then said when I asked if I could, yes, all the old men like to pinch my cheeks. I love telling that story.
If she wins the free skate, she wins her first world championship.
Been a phenomenal jumper. Now she has reinvented herself and her artistry and her image, and the costume has played a wonderful part in her presentation. Gives her a nice long line, and here she's opening with a triple Lutz, double toe.
No triple.
Or double loop.
Wonderful combination.
Her second combination, triple Salchow.
This is supposed to be with the double Salchow. Hey, look at that, the way she did that one.
Triple Salchow, triple.
No,
triple.
That one was a double. That one was a double.
The judges.
Now her triple Lutz. This takeoff. Good spring.
Into this next jump, a series of three turns, very difficult moves. Right there, one, two, three, and into the triple loop.
Turns very fast in the air, very efficient. Triple flip.
second one.
She does them both on the right foot and the left foot. These spirals are no match to Michelle Kwan's extension that she gets on hers, or Sarah Hughes.
Very unimaginative spiral sequence.
She's much more expressive with her music. Now her final jump, a triple toe. Very easy.
Mediocre spin position. Not a musical ending. Not a well-choreographed end of the program. In fact, the whole program was really not well-constructed.
I think it lost its focus. She only completed six triple jumps as opposed to seven that Michelle did.
And at the beginning of floating around trying to hit those triple-triple combinations and changing them, pulling them, I don't think will stand her in as good stead as we've seen that she's had earlier this year.
And it's important to note that Michelle Kwan can still win, even though she's behind Butyrskaya overall. Her free skate was judged better than Butyrskaya's. She needs someone else to beat Maria in the free skate as well.
You know, it's quite possible that the judges will not think this performance was as good as Butyrskaya's because of the floating around searching for the jumps.
And here's the jump she added in after she made a mistake on the first attempt. This triple salchow, double loop combination. Watch that free leg swing around. She really was determined to land it. And this was the three turns she did into the triple loop. This made this takeoff very difficult. And she made it look so easy. The Bielman spin that she does on the right foot and the left foot is spectacular. Good stretch. There she goes on the left foot first and swings around and grabs the foot and pulls it up over her head.
Now, if you're a figure skating aficionado, you know that standings can flip-flop depending on who places whom where with the judges. So now the first set.
You know, those are good marks. She is not an extraordinary technician. There's not a lot of really good technique in her spins and jumps. But these marks are steady and really complete marks and reflect the fact that she did some magnificent triple jumps.
And here are the important ones. Presentation, Dick.
They're very generous marks.
And it puts her in second place. Butyrskaya drops to third. It's exactly what has happened. There's your new leader. Michelle Kwan now leads here in Nice. And I'm not sure she knows it. If she knows it, she's the most composed person that I've ever seen.
That's really wonderful for her because she deserved it, and this is the perfect scenario.
So with her teammate having just vaulted into the lead, Sarah Hughes now gets her turn, the U.S. bronze medalist, who, like Peggy Fleming, finished seventh at her first trip to the Senior World Championships. And she's hoping that her lucky Peggy Fleming T-shirt brings her some luck tonight. She'll skate right after this word from our ABC stations. Who is about to be named world champion for the third time in her career. And the emotions of one whose comeback bid has come up just short.
On the ice, United States of
Sarah Hughes trying to finish a lot better than seventh, which she did last year. Kwan, Slutskaya, and Butyrskaya, your top three.
Wow. What a wonderful scenario that was.
Well, my predictions are pretty good.
Yes, they're wonderful.
Still trying to catch our breath here and everyone else in the arena. Sarah Hughes, fourth after the short programmer, second trip to Worlds.
Well, if her steadiness and elegance in the short programmer are any indication, this could be a memorable performance for this young lady.
Thank you.
triple-triple combinations. Triple Salchow, triple loop. First one, triple Salchow, triple loop. A little trouble on that landing.
She fell out of it, which will negate the total mark for it. But look at the stretch on this and the pointed toe. That's first rate. And she won't get as much credit for that kind of a spin as she should get. Judges simply do not give that much credit for spins in comparison to jumps.
Second set of triple jumps in combination, triple toe, triple loop. First one. Triple toe with a struggle on that triple loop.
You know, one of the problems here is that she has had to wait for five other ladies to skate, and that's very difficult. It's a long time since the warm-up. It's a lot of time to think about it all.
And it's a heck of a long time when you're 14 years old. Well, she is still technically too young to be here, but she medaled at the Junior World Championships last season. That's the rule that kept Sasha Cohen, the U.S. silver medalist, away from Worlds. She did not medal at Junior Worlds this season.
Well, don't tell her she's too young.
Triple Lutz, double toe.
Now, just watch the pre-leg here. Good stretch. Edges. Beautiful layback position.
I think she really feels this music. She hears it. She hits these accents so well.
Thing that intimidates her. And there is the person who will wear gold at the end of this evening. Now she knows, the first American to win a ladies' world crown three times since, Peggy Fleming. Back with Sarah Scores in a moment. Championships, very happy Sarah Hughes with her coach walking to the kiss and cry area.
And this combination, first a triple Salchow. Now watch the landing as she goes right up again into a triple loop. But she falls out of it, and that will cause a minor deduction. Now here on this double jump combination, again, she does a triple toe loop and a second loop into a second one, a loop, and again has the same trouble falling out.
Fourth place after the short program. First set.
Well, you know, those marks are really low. The fact is nobody else did triple-triple combinations. and she did everything else and did it with grace and style. So I think those marks are really telling her that she has to wait her turn a little bit.
Tells her that she's 14.
Yeah, they tell her that they think she's 14.
Presentation marks, and she drops from fourth to fifth place, right behind Vanessa Guzmaroli. But nothing to be disappointed about with her performance. But there's the gold medalist, Michelle Kwan. Well, they said she couldn't come in here and win. She struggled throughout the season. All of the life at UCLA, wanting a new life, experiencing more away from skating. Guess what? She got it together, and she's won again. So Peggy Fleming's got a future in Las Vegas. She picked Michelle Kwan to come back against the odds and win. That's exactly what she has done. Slutskaya, for the second time, wins the silver medal. And Maria Butyrskaya rounds out the podium. Sarah Hughes, what a great trip to the World Championships. She finishes in the top five. And Angela Nikodinov finishes ninth. Michelle Kwan has made her way back to have a word with Leslie right now.
Terry, for the second time in a week, an American beauty took home the prize. Congratulations to you, Michelle. It was so strong, so aggressive. Did that feel like the Michelle Kwan of old?
Geez, it felt like Michelle Kwan. That's all I could say. I don't know if it's the old, but it's the new, that's for sure. Frank, the words of encouragement right before I skated was, let it go. And I knew I was very confident, and I stepped out there. I knew what I had to do, and just let it go.
You know, for all the talk, you were the only one with a clean triple-triple. What makes that combination so hard?
You know, triple-triple is really difficult because the first triple is hard enough, right? But to do the second one, you have to have a lot of speed, and you have to be aggressive, no hesitation. And going into it, I said, okay, here goes nothing. I'm going for it.
Got it. Worked. Well, as you know, you've now tied Peggy Fleming, your third world championship. Is this your most satisfying?
I think this world championships is going to be the most memorable because I went out there and fought, had a little tough fight at the short program, but came out strong, and it feels good. It really does.
Oh, it was great. Well, you know, you always say it's not the process, it's the result. In this case, it was the result. Congratulations. Back to you, Terry.
Leslie, thanks. There you have it. Two behind Carol Heiss and tied with Peggy Fleming. In fairness, two of Peggy's world championships outside. She had to deal with the wind back then. Well, it's always sweet to win as the favorite, but even more satisfying to prove them all wrong. Top step of the podium time when we come back for Michelle. Same trio that stood on the podium at the 98 World Championships has the identical view right now. Another champion tomorrow. When the men take the ice, make sure you're with us. Our coverage starts at 1 o'clock Eastern. ABC Sports is online at abcsports.com, part of the Go Network. Good night, everybody.